Anyway, 'tis the season for holiday toys, and while your kids may be super psyched for all those little knickknacks, parents might be a little less excited.
So what toys do you get the unofficial, or which ones get the unofficial stamp of approval from parents in the know? Which ones will be more stressed than they're worth? Well, joining us, Julie and Kristen, back with us. They are the minds behind the blog Rants from Mommyland, and they have some thoughts on the issue of toy buying. Good to have you back with us,
How
ladies.
How are you guys?
Good, thank you.
Have you shopped yet? Yeah, that's a big question.
Done.
Are you serious?
Wonderful.
She's
wonderful. You're putting us all to shame.
How is your list going?
Let's not talk about it.
Really? That bad?
No, it's, we're getting there.
You're getting there. But the trees are up at your house. Mm-hmm. That's good, because I know that's a big to-do, you know, with kids.
I have a 2-year-old. My tree's going up Christmas Eve. Oh. Otherwise, she's going to climb it or knock it down. Or,
have you gotten that, like, non-breakable ornaments, that kind of thing for the lower ones? My sister did that because she has a 1-year-old. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it can get a little treacherous in the living room.
Right. Plus, I'm awkward, so I knock into the tree. So it's better to have things that aren't breakable at the bottom.
And also for putting them away. You know, the unbreakable is great. Because then
if they're breakable, then you don't have to put them away.
Oh, yeah. Which makes it.
Yeah, because they just break.
Well, you guys have a list of some disapproving mom toys. Well, kid toys that are disapproving by moms. So topping your list, is this in any particular order?
No, it's in no order at all.
Okay, just one. That you'd rather not have in your house.
Exactly.
Okay, and so dolls?
Dolls. Okay, well, we just want to start by saying that there's nothing wrong with these toys. The real issue with these toys is that they're too appealing. So all the kids want them, and they're more trouble than they're worth.
The first one is Baby Alive.
We also call that creepy robot baby.
Look at her.
Yeah, she's not cute. She's frightening. I'm not sure she doesn't come to life when you're sleeping and you find her next to your bed.
Mommy,
staring
wake
at
up.
You.
She has big eyes. Mm-hmm.
She does have
also,
big eyes.
Also, she
requires her own accessories for changing diapers. We have real children. Why do we want more diapers to change?
The doll urinates and defecates. Let's just put it
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
Yeah, no thanks.
There's also a very popular dog toy right now that eats and then
does the same thing.
Oh my goodness.
We're thinking we would like our children to experience the joys of that particular experience when they're adults.
Yeah.
And sleep, you know, not sleeping and 40.
Yeah, because who's really going to be cleaning this up?
Exactly.
For once, the kids are going to be into it, and then it's mom's thing, right?
I have an actual toddler that I'm potty training. I do not need another, you know, critter around to change or clean up after.
It seems to me that these dolls that sort of pee—they've been around for a while. I mean, little put the water in their mouth, and then.
I never knew ones end. That actually came down, but that's okay.
And how long do we really think that the children are going to find any interest in this? Second changing, and they're going to be like,
tired of this.
We're done.
Absolutely.
Next one, it's Barbie. Barbie glitterizer.
Well, and we love Barbie.
I aspired to be Barbie.
Everything girl did.
But the thing is that this particular Barbie, one of these particular Barbies, the one I have an issue with, and Julie has an issue with the other one, the tattooed Barbie, you know, we refer to that as hepatitis Barbie. We just don't need that in our house. So.
But this is the glitterizer Barbie. So basically, it's an armoire. It's a wardrobe.
Right.
And you put the doll in, and you close the doors, and it blows glitter everywhere.
No way.
Have
you
ever I would have died for this when I was 7.
Yeah, and your mother would have died for you to have it. Do you have any idea how hard it is to clean up glitter?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
It's like when you try and clean it up,
it's everywhere.
There's static on it, so you can't, and it gets on everything you own, and you're like Lady Macbeth trying to get the spot, and it won't go away.
4 months.
Yes.
And the thing we've also discovered is that girls who want Barbies have brothers who want hamsters, and the hamster can fit ever so perfectly into the glitterizer.
Exactly.
Which just turns into a second problem.
Oh,
so
no.
My son saw it, and he had a Zuzu pet, and he's like,
Mm-hmm.
And I'm thinking, reason number 10 not to get that.
Right, so we don't need the glitterizer Barbie. We don't need
the
tattoo Barbie.
Yeah, the other one, the total styling one, Barbie.
That Barbie comes with stampers for temporary tattoos and 40 actual tattoos. 40 tattoos. Barbies are not that big. So essentially, you're going to run out of space on the Barbie
for appropriate tattoos if there's
such a thing as appropriate tattoos, which I'm sure there are.
They can put the tattoos on themselves, right?
Right. Well, I mean, eventually the Barbie's going to end up with like a murder tat face tattoo. So it could be like California penal prison system Barbie, you know, and it would go from,
we love Barbies. Don't get us wrong. We love Barbies and the shoes and the whole thing.
I don't like Barbie shoes at 3 a.m. in the dark when I step on them and they break.
Yeah,
I don't need my kids to be like, I want to be just like her and have
40 tattoos. Mm-hmm. Or like Tramp Stamp Barbie.
Tramp Stamp
like,
Barbie.
That's the most. Oh, wow, she said it. That's hilarious. Let's move on to Bigfoot the Monster. What's up with this toy?
Bigfoot the Monster is about 2 feet tall and maybe 2.5 feet wide.
Okay.
And it's just like a Bigfoot critter, and it's remote controlled, and it's super cool, and all the kids love it and want it.
It's awesome. Except at 3 in the morning, when you don't have a place to put it.
Well, where do you store it when you're not playing with it? You can't put it on the couch. It's as big as the couch. If you put it in the closet, can you imagine if you forget it's there and open it up and you're like, hello, enormous Bigfoot?
And we have a theory that the size of toys that kids want is sort of inversely proportional to as long as they would be interested in them. So 6 weeks from now, you're going to have a giant monkey in your room that you don't need and don't want. So our theory is it's awesome. Kids are going to love it. Wait until June when all the other moms are getting rid of it at consignment sales as fast as they can.
There you
and
go.
Then you get it for $20.
Yeah, and it retails Perfect. Now for over $100. So
Does
it's
it really?
Extremely expensive, really hard to store, and they're probably not going to want to play with it for that
so
long.
So seriously, this is the size of what? Say like a vacuum cleaner?
Yeah, it is. I mean, that toy is bigger than my toddler. So, I mean, I want you to imagine like a little kid getting a toy that's as big as it is that's a monster. I mean, it would be terrifying for a toddler.
Just and how big it would look to somebody that's this little.
I know, although mine would probably try and attack it, so we would have like a Bigfoot toddler cage match, which might be funny, but ultimately
All right,
not
Matchbox Stinky, the garbage truck?
Oh,
what's this? Matchbox, I'm thinking Matchbox, little Matchbox cars, but that's not what this is?
It's pretty big. It's not
huge. Yeah, sure it is.
Yeah, it's,
This is the master toy of pull my finger.
It's a flatulent garbage truck.
And I already have that happening in the house in the form of my husband and my sons. Mm-hmm. So why do we need a toy that we strongly encourage that not to happen in our house?
I mean, there's an affinity with boys and trucks, and there's an affinity with boys and pull my finger. So it's a natural that they would create this toy. I just don't want it in my house.
Okay. Too many stinky things running around.
It's kind of creepy crawlers. What is that one?
Okay. Creepy crawlers is a toy that's been around for ages. My husband, apparently, I just found out, wanted one desperately when he was a kid and didn't get it. It's a bug-making machine where you put all kinds of gel in it, and it forms a big sort of squishy bug. But this current version is you form the bugs, and you squash them, and goo comes out.
Lovely.
Really. I mean, let's be honest. If the joy of this toy is in squashing bugs until they go squish, why do I have to kill all the spiders in my house? You know, if that's what you want to do.
You put those kids to work,
exactly.
Right?
Go down in the basement, take care of business. I don't
Does that gooey stuff get in, like, the carpeting and everything? And
that and the glitter and the moon sand, and you've essentially waged war on my vacuum cleaner for the next year.
Yeah. Next up, moon sand ice cream.
Oh. Moon sand might be the sort of most nefarious of all of the toys that we're talking about today, because that particular one, it looks like delicious ice cream.
Right.
It's not food. So I want you to imagine playing with that with a very young child who's going to be like, oh, ice cream. It's not ice cream. And moon sand is also designed to cling together. When you drop sand on the floor, it's easy to vacuum up or sweep up. This is designed to stick to whatever it touches. You can't clean it up.
This is a bad version of Play-Doh. And we figure if you're going to start creating things that sort of look like other things, let's just go with Play-Doh. We are huge proponents of Play-Doh.
Yeah, don't buy a Play-Doh substitute. Just get Play-Doh.
I spend my life trying to keep dirt out of my house. This is just inviting it in a colorful box.
It's just another thing.
You need a new vocabulary to talk about toys when you don't have little ones around.
To decipher what it is,
I had never heard of moon sand, but it sounds just awful, doesn't it?
Yeah, and it looks wonderful, and it's terrible because they advertise it constantly. So every show that your kids want to watch, this is being advertised.
We want moon sand. Must have it.
And yet when you take them to the beach, they can't get away from sand fast enough. So.
Okay, what's the next
one? Anything else? We have the Nerf and Strike 3-in-1 utility power system.
Right, and this is another thing we should say. I'm not a real purist about especially boys wanting to play kind of violent games or rough games or play with guns. I'm not encouraging my kids to do that. But this is, what are you going to do with that? That's like, let's play Attack Tora Bora. That's an assault weapon. It launches. It has like a shoulder thing.
I don't know. It could be a lot of fun.
It could be a lot of fun.
If you're older.
But they're not going to aim it at trees and rocks and the stray
dog.
Thank you, Natasha. That's right. Either the dog or their sister is going to be the recipient of those Nerf darts.
Right. That have the sticky things. Mm-hmm. So they.
Exactly. And who's going to have to negotiate that peace treaty? mom.
Yeah.
And I'm not interested.
You can just hear them now running to you and saying, Mommy, so-and-so hurt me.
The wars on Christmas afternoon. You can see it happening.
Are any of these currently in your house or you had to take out of your house secretly in the middle of the night from your children?
If you ask my 7-year-old about Baby Alive, she'll say, I had it and then it peed on me and then Mommy donated it.
So some other parent will have to deal with it down the line.
We have sad versions of it. We have the dump trucks and the garbage trucks because trucks are really big in our house. And I just say, make the noises or, you know, pull each other's fingers. And then they think that's fine.
And just work from that?
Work from that. Use your creativity. So fortunately, no. Mm-hmm. Those are kind of banned in our house.
I wish I could remember. There was a toy I bought for my niece like a Christmas or two ago at Toys R Us, and I thought it was great, and she cried and did all that cute little stuff until we couldn't shut the toy up. It was like in the trunk. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Oh, those are for reals. Have you seen those? The little dogs?
And they'll bark. I forget what it is.
And they bark, and it's awesome. They do this little bark, and then they walk around. And then when I had it in the backseat of my car, because we got it for a friend, because these are excellent revenge gifts.
I had when to you return it. My sister made me return it.
When somebody buys your children drum sets, these are the gifts you give back to their kids. But the dog was in the backseat of our car for about 30 seconds before it turned Cujo and feral and was losing its mind.
Take it in the backseat. That is that company's doll.
Yeah, and I already have a dog that's weird and barks at strange objects like the closet. I don't need a fake one that does the same
Although
thing.
Although for real, pets are huge Christmas. All of the kids want them, and I think that they're actually better than a lot of the things that we've talked about. So if your choice is moon sand or a noisy puppy, you can just take the battery.
Take the puppy. All right, so anything that's too messy or too noisy or can be used as a lethal weapon, that's not on the list this year.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for cluing us in on the toys to buy. Julie and Kristen from Rants from Mommyland. Always fun to have you guys.
Good luck this Christmas.